The wetlands are, they're just incredible ecosystems. They are among the most biodiverse on the planet. They rival coral reefs and tropical rainforests.
This is a herring gull. That's the standard seagull.
About 75% of the shellfish and fish rely on wetlands for part of their life cycle. And then there's a whole host of species that rely on them, coastal birds, diamondback terrapins, horseshoe crabs. There's just a wealth of wildlife here.
Because this is a hugely important migration corridor. So these birds are returning from probably high Arctic nesting.
They filter water and help with pollution. They store carbon to help with climate change, but they also provide coastal resilience for our coastal communities. So they protect us from storms, storm waves, and flooding in really important ways.
It's a pair of osprey that mate here. The platforms are where they nest. They mate for life, which is really kind of cool, but they winter apart, maybe the secret to a good marriage. There are water people and there are mountain people, right? I'm definitely a water person. I can connect to it, the rhythm of the tides.
So Wetlands Institute is a nonprofit. We have a mission of promoting appreciation, stewardship, and understanding of wetlands and coastal ecosystems. We do it through applied research programs that translate to conservation actions, and then education programs to try to connect people to nature and have people understand the importance of these ecosystems and how to steward them. We're in Stone Harbor, New Jersey. New Jersey is very rich in wetlands, so there's thousands of acres of preserved wetlands here. So historically, the biggest threat to wetlands was development. In the late 60s, early 70s, wetlands protection rules came in through the Clean Water Act, and we started understanding the importance that wetlands had for wildlife as well as for people. Now the biggest threat to wetlands is actually rising seas. NOAA estimates we're losing about 80,000 acres of coastal wetlands a year. We start having higher losses related to flooding, storm events, and just, you know, threatening the coastal way of life that's so important to New Jersey and the whole eastern seaboard of the United States. But then we start losing fish, we start losing our fisheries, we start losing those services, we start losing the wildlife that are here. Or we'll certainly see shifts in how these ecosystems are used. They'll be winners and losers, and some species are going to do not so well and other species will do well. And we spend a lot of our time trying to either restore that foundation or doing conservation efforts to support the wildlife that are most threatened.
Snowy egret, they nest in the area. They summer here, in the winter they head further south.
We're doing a lot of work right now on marsh restoration, where we can try to demonstrate how we can use clean dredge material that we need to dredge to keep our waterways safe. We can use it to raise the marsh elevation. So as the water gets deeper on the marshes, the flooding gets higher. If we can raise that marsh elevation back up to those critical flood levels, we can restore marshes. And since 2019, we've stored about 85 acres of marshes.
This is more osprey.
Cape May in general is one of the best flyways in the world, and the birds funnel through here in both directions during migration. We're in the southbound migration now, and in the southbound migration, we add a lot of raptors come through in addition to all the wading birds, shorebirds. It's a highway that goes from the high Arctic all the way down to the southern end of South America. And everyone funnels right here before they continue to jump south. There are a lot of osprey here, but there are not a lot of osprey in other parts of the country. This is a destination for folks that come to the shore, so we offer all kinds of educational programs. We're open to the public, so we do guided walks. We have two aquariums where they can see some of these animals up close and personal that you might not see otherwise. We have a quarter mile trail, we have a raised elevation walkway, so people can see the marsh without impacting the marsh.
There's a remarkable diversity of life here. You just gotta take a minute to find it or let it come to you. But it really is beautiful, and these marshes are just so special. It's so nice that they're preserved and protected.